Thank you. If anyone would like to make $11 an hour. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yes, we're going to bring it to see the work.
Thank you. So it means that.
It means the worker will say.
Right, Scott.
Discussion.
Teachers, retail professional, and professionals. And all of a sudden, lots of them.
Yeah.
It's all being a longer. There's 17.39 full-time equivalent, so there's, you know, some percentage we give every teacher.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah. And there are 15 paraprofessionals.
So this is a one person, this is a second office.
How many teachers have that?
So what is the actual?
Total is, you know, 43,299 total increase for the paraprofessionals. It's not the same for each because some of them are off step. So we're adjusting those people that are off step to be on the appropriate step. So.
It's very difficult to say what happens to each individual person. What this is accomplishing is we create, many years ago, and some of you are very familiar with this, we had an administration that hired people at any rate they decided to hire people at a paraprofessional level. And so we had paraprofessionals who were widely divergent in what they were making, even though they might have the same experience and have the same education. And so what this does is it creates a step schedule, and it puts every paraprofessional on the correct step level, so this will not happen again. And there will never have such widely disparity. If you're a first-year paraprofessional with the same education as another first-year paraprofessional, you will make the same salary, the same hourly wage.
But so is there a rule?
Well, in a way, this is moving people to where they belong on the salary scale. They're not really getting an increase. Technically they're getting an increase, but they're not getting a raise in pay. They're moved to where they belong on the salary scale.
Yeah, for example, you've got some people that are making $10.50 an hour, and the lowest of our scale is $12, and they're not on them. So this just appropriately gets them to the appropriate. You may have somebody that's been here for, gosh, I don't know, 15, 20 years, that may be two and three steps off of the existing schedule. So it might be, they might be making $12 an hour when the actual step that they should be at is $14 or $15 an hour. So it depends a great deal, like you said, on how long they've been here, what they were hired at. I mean, we've got people all over the place. The other benefit of this, in addition to getting everybody on the correct step, is that it will now allow me to hire people at the appropriate step. Where I was this year, because I can't hire somebody at a higher rate than an existing employee, which isn't fair. So if I've got somebody making, I use the 10.50 example. If I've got somebody making 10.50 an hour and I have somebody coming in, I can't put them at the bottom step of $12. I'm hiring them at below the appropriate step. So it just, it allows us to get everybody at least to the appropriate step.
Thank you. I have a question. Is that a mental problem to get some number of, so your current professional salary?
Yep.
And which, what is the professional, which is your professional, what's the budget?
That's $43,000.
$43,299.
So.
Are you looking for like an hourly change?
So if someone, I go back to the budget, I look at, like, the professionals, I'll see, I'm getting salary, I'll see, $300,000, last year's $300,000. Yes. Okay, my other question is going forward then, are they all going to be on an automatic step by teachers or not?
Yes. The salary.
Right, the contract passes.
The salary schedule is, has already been, for paraprofessionals, has already been approved in the existing collective bargaining agreement. So that salary hourly wage pay is presently in this year's collective bargaining agreement. Unfortunately, there's also a line in the collective bargaining agreement that says that I can't hire anybody at a higher rate than an existing employee. And we've got a lot of existing employees that aren't even on that schedule because of contracts that have been passed and other things in the last decade. So this stabilizes so many issues.
Okay, so step goes according to the contract. It's not like the teachers were going to get tracks and not going.
There's five steps. Step one is $12, all the way up to step five is $16.
It's not an automatic unless the contract passes.
Step isn't on that, on the teachers either.
Right. Yeah, it's, yeah.
You would have to pass another collective bargaining.
Yeah, collective bargaining.
Can I just interject a second? I don't know if it's not a few, but somewhere in the discussion, where some of the level is 5% math per year. So say someone's getting an average of 2% raise and hold that level. About 5%. Is that correct? Do I understand that somewhere?
Okay. That's not the way this is. First of all, this is because the professionals are part of the union, it has to be a union agreement on how this is done. And so the school board felt very strongly that we needed to really address the inequities of the parent.
Right, I get all that. What I'm trying to get at is if someone, okay.
We move everyone, regardless of how much of an increase they get. Everyone's going to be no more inequity. And making the superintendent's and the principal's job so much difficult in terms of trying to hire someone at a much lower rate, because even if they deserve to be a hire.
Well, you know, that's why you sort of, I guess, to do this question last year. Have you got people you want up to that step level, or are you still doing
this
will do that.
Okay.
This doesn't. Remember, this isn't in, there's no increase in the paraprofessional salary schedule. What is in the collective bargaining agreement this year is going to be the exact same schedule in the collective bargaining agreement next year if this passes. All it does is put everybody on the correct step where they should be already.
This schedule passed last year. They already went on this pay schedule that Kate laid out. It's just that many of them aren't actually where they should be on that schedule. So we're bringing them to where they should be on the existing schedule. Does that make sense?
And now you want that.
Yeah. And that is an increase of 43 to 90.
So just as a public calls, just a question. So if I were to look at aides, tutors, and subs,
can you clarify one more time how the steps is going to be? Is it based on years of service?
Mm-hmm.
So year one is it's $12 an hour, and then it goes up.
Five
years and seven.
So they cap out.
So how many people are going to be on the bottom? get the.
We're getting the number now, but you've got.
We have nine at step five of the process.
Yeah, we're pretty fortunate, and we've got some very experienced.
So that's what's going to say, that we need to go out.
I think Paul was talking about the 5%. I think we were talking about 5% is on the teachers. A step raise or a track raise is 5%. That's where he's getting the 5%. Am I right?
Well, the step and track is 5%, yeah. One way and down, yeah. But your per scale will increase if you're going like next year, and you have, I don't know how many years this is going to be. Okay, so next year you're going to do this all over again, and if you give them a 2% increase, your step scale is going to go up 2% for each step. So they don't, you don't have an automatic, yeah, it's different than the teachers.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to.
But it stays five. The only thing that changes is what they get for their increase. Right. So this isn't an automatic. Right.
So.
Very good, Tom.
Thank you. Great day.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah.
You add them all up. Yep.
I agree with that.
Yep.
Oh, just to make sure the calculations were good on the pose versus the last year. So when I was doing that, I found this. So I think we're okay there, but I would get that. Yeah. Oh, that, well, we talk about it on the night. Yes, we will have a corrected copy. Hopefully you will have a divorce and you can find something that you can talk about at that night.
Thank you.